Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, wa salatu wa salam ala Sayyidil Mursaleen, wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'een. Topic of the day is the possibility of Day of Judgment, the Day of Resurrection. As promised by all the prophets and especially by the last prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, peace be upon him, and the last book, Al-Qur'an. Today we shall see the argument given in Surat Luqman, ayah number 33. Surat Luqman, ayah number 33. And you see, Ya ayyuhan nas, ittaqu rabbakum, O mankind. You see, the address is towards entire mankind, not specifically to Muslims or Arabs, no, not at all. Ya ayyuhan nas, ittaqu rabbakum. Fear your Lord, your Rabb, your sustainer, your provider, who is providing you all the provisions necessary for life, for your life on this planet of earth. اتقوا ربكم واخشوا يوما لا يجزي والد عن ولدي. What shall happen on the day of judgment? واخشوا يوما لا يجزي والد عن ولده. A day, fear the day in which father will not be able to reward on behalf of his son. Father is not going to save his son. He will not be permitted to do so. He cannot reward. لا يجزي والد عن ولده. So this, every man is responsible for his own deeds. Every man shall be asked about his own deeds. The son will not be asked about his father's deed. The father shall not be asked about his son's deed. Father may not be a believer, and the son may be a believer. And similarly, vice versa. وَلَا مَوْلُودٌ هُوَ جَازٍ عَنْ وَالِدِهِ شَيْءٍ. And the son will not be able to reward on behalf of his father. إِنَّ وَعَدَ اللَّهِ حَقًّا. In fact, the promise of God, وَعَدَ اللَّهِ حَقًّا, that is a truth, total truth, absolute truth, that the day of judgment shall happen. Men should not be in any doubt. It shall happen. إِنَّ وَعَدَ اللَّهِ حَقًّا. It is inevitable. It shall happen. It shall occur. فَلَا تَغُرَّنَّكُمُ الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا. O mankind, this dunya, this world, the activities and the attractions of this world shall not deceive you. You see, man is deceived by the attractions of this world. Lot of money, dollars, good food, women, animals, cars, the blessings of this world, man is attracted towards them. And then he forgets who he is. He forgets the purpose of his life on this planet of earth. He forgets his creator God. And he forgets his future. He does not think that he is going to die soon. He thinks this dunya is permanent. We must enjoy here. He is so much attracted by this dunya. See, this is the test. This dunya, this world is made very attractive. Attractive for mankind. So Allah says, this shall not be able to deceive you. وَلَا تُغَرَّنَّكُمْ وَالْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا وَلَا يَغُرَّنَّكُمْ بِاللَّهِ الْغَرُورِ. And the Shaitan, the one who deceives the entire mankind, Iblis, the jinn, shall not be able to deceive you. Stay away from Shaitan. Stay away from his trap. So this ayah, number 33 of Surat Luqman, calls and invites all mankind to accept the Day of Judgment, a day in which all dead people shall be raised again from their graves. Inna wa'dallahi haqqun. No doubt, man should have no doubt about this day of reward and punishment. Second thing, we knew from this ayah that we have to do something for our own selves. Our behavior shall be judged. We should be good citizens. We should be good father, good husband, good wife, good children, and good relatives, and good member of this society. And father is not going to help us help the son, and the son is not going to save his father. Every man shall be responsible for his own faith and his own deeds. And we should not be deceived by the attractions of this world. And we should not be deceived by Shaitan. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين واستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم.